What's going on, Killer Gameplays here. Gonna recap the last level with a little reading. It says, so the Holy Grail was a cursed object in the most famous legend to lie. I guess this is another forbidden fruit to punish away the will of man to retrieve his immortality lost by Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. The Templars were wise men, and now chaos is spreading all over the world because of me. It's all my fault. I don't want to know what will happen when the hourglass will be done. Fortunately, according to the writing I found in Megiddo, there's an antidote to the curse, the holy oil, which is said to be hidden somewhere at the outpost of hell, where there are some kind of mechanism to open the way, but because of its dangerousness, the Vatican has buried it in the Sistine Chapel. The news say that the city has barricaded itself, but sewer channels are really close to the underground floors of the museum at some points. Some C4 will certainly do the trick. So we'll pick up some flares. We just looked at a keyhole we need a key for, and that will open this sewer. And we definitely got an apocalyptic night here. We've got a red sky, boiling red sky. There's a pharmacy to the left. Let's pick up these other flares. I don't know why I never use them. Maybe I'll need them somewhere in the next level or two. But we'll go up here. We can jump to this flagpole, swing over, and get to a hidden switch. Just going to eyeball it. And we'll start out here with some tricky jumps. This is some of that water that'll catch you on fire if you get too deep into it. And we're going to work our way around. There's a large med pack. And under the desk, the counter here, is the keys we need. Cool. Just got to get back out of here. When we get back outside, there'll be a couple more hellhounds to come out. A couple of Rottweilers, half zombie, half dog. They are very quick, so we'll do what we can with them. Whoa, one behind me. Die. All right. Use the key over here and open the sewer. Get this adventure started. This particular level, we're doing more searching than anything. We do have a boss fight, and we see there's water in the sewer. We need to drain this water. There's a switch over here. Bust this barricade, and I just want to show you what's going on here so this will make sense. It won't take but a second to show you. We got to do a time swim. This fan will pull us in if we don't stop it. Here's the hatch we're opening, so we need to get a metal pipe and stick it in that fan and stop it. So when we do the timed run, we don't get chopped into pieces. And the metal pipe is over this way. We got a room over here full of poisonous gas. There is a hidden gem in here, so we'll go ahead and take care of that first. And what I like to do is just get a run and jump and actually just swan dive over. Get as much air as we can to jump over here. and we'll pull up and get back out of this before it starts taking any life. And the metal pipe is right above us, so we need to go over this way. Try to get lined up here as best we can. And get up above this gas in this area. Run, jump, press the action button, slide under the roof. The ceiling, and here's the iron bar we need. And we get a large med pack for our trouble. Actually, before I go deactivate the fan, I'll just show you. This is the upper part of the trap door we're opening for the time swim, and here's the switch. So just laying everything out so you know what's up. Walk up to the fan and select it. Ta-da! Now we can get some water in here. Press the time switch and do the time swim. Not really that bad if you don't waste any time. Shouldn't have any problems. Go ahead and save progress in case I mess it up. And we'll just jump over the railing right about in here. Save a little time and swim up quickly and pull up. And you can see the door just closed right behind us, so just enough time. Get a small med pack. We'll actually take that. We've got to blow up this boiler right here with some C4 that Laura's got in her backpack. We need to open this door. This room in here is going to be our protection when the blast goes off. So we got 10 seconds to do this. We'll place the C4. Run back in this room. Hit this button. Close the door. The shutter door real quick. And duck down. Depending on how fast you shut that door, you want to make sure you got plenty of health, because it might kill you. So we'll jump over these fires, do a half tile jump over this one, and pull up in a crawl space. And this is our way to the Vatican Museum. And I hope everybody's having a good day. Thanks for tuning in to Killer Gameplays. We got a couple more levels in this game. Something tells me the last two levels are going to be really cool, so we'll stay tuned for that. And we'll press this switch and there's an office over to our left. There's an email from the chief of security in there, I'll go ahead and read it. It says, after the recent events, the museum has been closed, as some priests are still going to the chapel. Only basic alarm systems are on. But if an intrusion is detected, an elite patrol is ready to step in, and armored doors will seal off the main access. I will stay in the security office to keep my eye on the situation. At the moment, evil creatures did not manage to enter the city, but it's just a matter of time. God be with us. So she can't trigger any alarms. And it's there's laser beams all through this museum that we need to jump over and avoid. Otherwise, it'll shut the game down. You just have to start over. So we'll avoid that. We'll go up into the museum here and notice that there's a metal detector to our right. Get a cutscene. So we can't go through the metal detector with the guns. We need to drop them right here on the shelves. And we will be back to get them. As I was saying, there's a boss in this area. It's three Hydras. And we have three ways we can go. We'll go over to the right. We can get our crowbar over here. This is the religious art museum over here. And these lasers, you'll notice that one side's closer to the wall than the other, so we can use this one side and just sidestep. Just want to make sure her nose is up against the wall. And then we'll shimmy and get by this next one. Alright, we can go left or right. We'll go to the right. And we need to move this chandelier up and down to be able to access the crowbar. We're just going to work our way straight ahead. And we'll move this display over to the banister. Got some chains, different chains on different balconies. We're going to pull this one twice, raise the chandelier, and now that we have the display where it needs to be, we can jump to it. Get up higher, and we'll push open these double doors to the left and access some stairs. That will lead us to another balcony. We got three different chains we need to pull. Here's the second one. We're going to pull it three times. Raise the chandelier up some more. Jump across, access another switch. Go through another set of double doors to the third chain. And we need to pull this chain 5 times. We're going to lower the chandelier. Get lined up here. Come on, Laura. This will line us up. The crowbar is straight ahead, so we'll do a half tile jump. And the crowbar's right here. Finally. Drop back down the floor, and we're done in this area. We're going to go straight ahead through this hallway, and we can avoid one laser trap by going this way. Right here. And we'll notice that the wide gap for the lasers is on this side. So we'll just push her nose to the wall and sidestep and head back out to the museum main hall. This time we're going to go straight ahead. We will access that area to the left and finally the one to the right. There's a couple of objects we need in here. Now that we got the crowbar, we need to... There's a security officer in here. We need to smack him on the head and get a key from him. Also, there's a laser sight in this area that we need for the crossbow. So that's our purpose for being in here. Got some more lasers in display. And we're just going to pull up and turn to the right just a little bit, just so we can side flip and miss this laser. There's an air vent up here we can get to if we pull this empty display case back and push it forward. So I got 2 more levels in this TRLE, and I want to go ahead and finish up Anniversary. And then, to be honest, I'm probably going to do some streaming for my other channel, Premiere Playthroughs. But I will be doing some streaming for Killer Gameplays eventually. But I'll try to keep some kind of game going. Let's light a flare. Keep this channel alive. If nothing else, but, you know, one TRLE. Come up in here. We've got a couple of cabinets, one to the left, there's nothing in there, and this one straight ahead to the right, there's our laser sight for the crossbow. Yep, got some good internet, got some killer games for the PlayStation Pro. Gonna be doing some streaming. We'll get a cinematic here. There's a guard in here just sitting in here waiting for us to go in there and knock him in the head, get his keys. So we'll crawl over there to him. You could press the walk button and walk. I think this is actually a little quicker. Stand up behind him, select the crowbar?
No.
Don't tell me no.
No.
Dang, girl. Hit him on the head.
Whack.
Alright, let's get his keys. That's the two things we need in this area. And we're just going to head back out the way we came in. And it's going to be neat to do some streaming. It's neat to just play a game, not have to do a perfect walkthrough or something. Just play the game. So that's, I'm going to do a little bit of that. I might even play through a game and, you know, perfect it and then do a walkthrough for it. But I want to stream on Twitch and then share my videos to YouTube. So if you want to get in on some of that, you have to subscribe to Premier Playthroughs. Be happening very soon. Plus the PlayStation Pro is compatible with a 4G TV. I'll have to get one of those. Got a little bit better graphics. I think you can stream in 1080 instead of 720. And not to mention it has more memory. Got a terabyte hard drive in it, which is plenty enough for me. I think I've got like 30 games stored on it. More than I could play in a couple of years, so, or longer than that. So let's go up to this top area. We haven't been up here, and use this key. We're fixing to enter into an area where the Hydras are, a boss. But first we have to do a timed run to get into a door. Need to jump over some lasers. So we'll press this button, flip around, run and jump, then jump again, then duck and roll forward, then jump again, get in the door. And we'll go to the left and trigger the Hydras. They are guarding a switch right here to let us get the key to the Vatican or the Sistine Chapel. And their flame goes around corners too, so we're going to run forward and we will be back to deal with those guys. Nasty little suckers. It's take a lot of ammo to kill, so I've got a little tactic for those guys. I'm not gonna jump back and forwards, and man, let me see if I can get in here. Set the action button. There we go. I'm not gonna jump around the corner left and right and left and right, and the fight take 20 minutes. I've found a better way to deal with them. I'll show you. So the first thing we need to do is drop down here. We'll grab a med pack. And we've got a two switch triggering system for this door we need to open. To get to the upper balcony, there's a card we need up there to be able to get our guns back. Get a bypass door for that metal detector. So that's what we're working on. We're trying to open that door. There's switch number one. But, and we'll go around here to this pillar and work our way up. Some of the games I'm be streaming though, I've got Soma, I've got some Resident Evil games, Resident Evil 4, 5, and 6. I've got The Division. I've got Bloodborne. I've got Assassin's Creed Syndicate, The Evil Within, Phantom Pain. All my favorite games like that. So I'll do that, plus I'll be doing my TRLEs on this channel. I have one going on that. But you only have so much time. There's a hidden ladder around here. You only have so much time, you have to prioritize. So it'd be some streaming over there, and then one TRLE over here. Because between my work and everything else I got going on, that's all I can do. So we're working up here. We got a med pack here, large med pack. And a few tricky jumps to get to the second switch. Sidestep. Jump to the left around the corner. And we'll just side flip here. And finally, we can open the doors there. Jump forward. Pretty tricky jumps here. Run, jump forward around this corner. And access this upper balcony above the hydra. The hydra are over to our left. So we want to run around here, hit this sloped roof, jump over the banister, and use the crowbar here. You want to be quick though, because as you can see, that fireball just missed me. So you can die right here very easy. Want to be quick right there. Grab a small med pack. Then we can finally get the access card to bypass the metal detector to get our guns. So that's what all that was about. So we're going to go jump over to the left, drop down to the ground, and it's pure luck if you don't get hit with a ball of fire. You might drop down there and 10 times and get hit with fire. Then again, you might do it once and make it just fine. So, we need to head back to where the guns are. Roll forward. And we don't want to trip a laser, man. It'll just start the game over. Come on, Laura. Jump forward. There we go. The ultimate goal is to get the key to the Sistine Chapel over to the left over there. Up at the top of the steps, we'll swipe the card, open the door to the bypass for the metal detector, and finally get our guns back. And we can do some fight on that Hydra. We need to clear them out of the way so we can access that switch to keep the game going. But before you leave here, over to the left, there's a grating we can shoot out. So we'll equip the guns and light a flare. And here we go, the second and final gym for this level. But I gotta say, man, this game's been pretty cool. I've liked it. You kind of take a chance when you pick a TRLE, but I've enjoyed it. Definitely not easy, but I like that. And let's go over here and do some battle with these Hydras and defeat them. I'm not going to be talking a lot while the gunfire is going on, because you won't be able to hear me. But we're going to save progress, take a small med pack. First thing we got to do is run over to the left, pick up some flare, so I'll do that. And we're going to run over here. I'm going to run up close and attack them diagonally, do jumps diagonally. You see their fire goes around objects, so I'm going to run up here and just jump back and forth diagonally. It screws them up. We'll see if I die or not. Let's try it again. Alright, let's get up a little closer. Cool beans. All right, man. Now we can access this lever. And just by having a little balls and running up to it, we've turned a 45-minute fight into just a couple of minutes. So can't be scared, man. You gotta just go for it. Press this switch and we'll open a door to an area where the key to the Sistine Chapel is. But we got a couple things to do first. Bust this barricade and around the back side of this right statue. Which is going to open a door for us so we can keep going. We'll drop down into this basement, but you want to be careful. There's glass down here on the floor. Get in the water and we'll jump up and avoid the lasers. Get up to the top of the steps. There's more lasers up here. We're going to jump, get on top of the water, and do some tight angle jumps right here. Get to this lever in the back. That'll open another door for us, so to get to the key. And this is a pretty tricky area, it was for me. See, even there, you hit your head on the ceiling, so pretty tricky. Get over here, jump, and swim through the lasers again. Need to get back up to where we were. So we'll find our spot in the floor. Jump, grab. Start working our way up. There's a block over here. We can run and jump to this slanted block in the middle of the floor. Shimmy to the left. Slide forward and grab. Alright. Cool. Let's go over to the left. We're going to jump to a chandelier. And we'll climb up this chain and get to another air vent. Light a flare. And we'll flip out of this crawl space. Access the key to the Sistine Chapel. Had to do all this to get the key. Had to defeat the Hydra. Just part of it. Jump, flip. We'll get rid of this flare. Head back to the main hall in the museum. Jump over these lasers for the very last time. So we got quite a bit going on here in this chapel. First thing we're going to do is there's one of those zombie Rottweilers in here. We need to deal with him. First thing. Go back here and find this dead priest, and she writes something in her diary. By the way, there's some my favorite Tomb Raider 1 music playing. I'm definitely a Tomb Raider geek from way back. Here's our crossbow. But if you play the game, and some ammo too, you'll see in her diary she gives you a couple of pictures for a clue where you need to shoot with this crossbow. There's two different places we need to shoot. As you can see, the murals up here. What you need to do is focus in. I'll focus in on this first one. And just refer to the screenshots in her diary. There's one. We're going to open some portals up. There's one there. For some reason, Bandicam's not showing those pictures. There's two. And the third one's over here. This is going to spawn some harpies. There's four harpies. I'm going to lure them back into the other room. And I'm not going to talk while I'm shooting and fighting them. So I'll see you in a few. We'll be right back. All right. Another thing that's dead, it opened, there's a puzzle on the floor. We need to line these dark spots up and trigger another portal. So we're going to go to the southeast button. We're going to step on it twice. As you step on these, it'll turn the mechanism in the middle of the floor. Go to the southwest once, press it. Go to the northeast once. Well, that was the northwest, and this is northeast twice. And there we go. Basically, we need to work our way up the scaffolds and jump into that blue sphere. I'm going to save the game right here. Save the game. Run jump to the blue sphere. And she'll wake up at the first of the next level. So I appreciate you watching. You're watching Killer Gameplays. Catch me on the next level. Take it easy.